Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name is Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is the Ubiquiti UniFi Cloud Gateway Ultra. What a mouthful, I always get that wrong, but that's what it is. So what is it? Well, I'll show you a little bit more about this in a moment. This is a box opening. It's nothing more than that. If you want to see a bunch of things of how it performs, how to set it up, head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got much more over there, but this is about showing you what you've got in the box. So you are going to get your conformity guide. Here's your conformity guide. You probably won't take that out of the plastic wrap. You are going to get, drop it on here, a tiny, tiny little thing of feet. They really are super thin there. If you just want to lift it slightly off the bench so it maybe has no chance of catching something and make it dirty, you get a 30 centimeter Ethernet cable. Remember, these cables from Ubiquiti, they measure from this point to this point when they give their sizes, and they miss this off. This makes it almost 40 centimeters in total length. You are going to get a power pack. It is powered by USB-C. We're here in Australia and there isn't an Australian model, so ours come with the European connectors on it. We leave these in the pack, but we do send you a new power pack to go with this with an Australian connector on it. There you can see the USB-C on this side. All right, so that is what you get in the box. What is this? Well, we've been waiting for this a bit. This builds on the Ubiquiti UniFi Express, the UX, and also probably builds in some ways on the UXG-Lite, which has two ports, so WAN and a LAN. This builds on it because we've got five ports. We've got options for some switch ports or multiple internet connections and load balancing. So, like I said, not gonna be a big techno overview, but hopefully give you a few bits as we go through. So nothing really to see on the front, probably won't even catch even the logo on there because it's so white. Our front screen, so just so this is a sort of polycarbonate style housing, pretty solid and dense. We've got little screen on the front here. This will show you the status, whether it's booting, what's happening on there, so fairly useful. We do have a number of customers who've returned the UniFi Express, and probably this at some point thinking that it actually is faulty because the screen goes off. By default in the controller software, it turns itself off at nighttime. So around about 8 o'clock, I think it is, this goes blank. And some people think, and you can't get it, turn it back on. You can turn the unit off and turn it back on, it's still blank. So can I suggest that you first check, you can change the setting so it's on all of the time. The unit probably isn't faulty, it's just a little bit of a night saving option on it. Nothing to see on the bottom. And then we have everything that we need over on this side. So here, this finger here, this one here, all right, this is our USB-C power in. All right, and then we have, which one are we doing? Oh, look at this, here we go. This is a bit illogical. Right here, this one here. This is our first WAN connection. So you have single WAN, obviously connected to your ISP. This is not a DSL modem. So if you have fiber to the node and it comes in over a copper pair, over a phone line, this won't work with it. You need to have a modem in front of it. If you've got fiber to the property, fiber to the curb, you've got a termination box and basically an Ethernet cable, this plugs straight in. So that's gonna go out to your internet connection. Here we go. All right, then you have basically a four port switch, and you can do a number of options with this. These are all 1 gig ports. All right, you have the option if you want to add another WAN connection. So you can do basic round robin and failover. So maybe you've got a 4G connection, maybe you've got Starlink in one and you've got 4G in another, or Starlink and NBN or something like that, then you can use it, this device, to balance over those connections. Right up this far end here, we've got our little reset switch. Let me hold that up there for you. All right, and that is really all of the items that you actually get on it. So what does this give us? Well, very simply, if you're new to Ubiquiti, then you need a controller to run all of the software that Ubiquiti has. You can either download that and install that onto your computer, you can use an app on your phone, but it's then very much linked to that device. If you lose that device and you're not taking a backup, you have to factory default all of the equipment. So Ubiquiti have a range of what are called OS controllers or OS consoles. These are things like the UDM SE and UDM Pro, which run multiple things. Like they can run UniFi Protect, which is the camera network, UniFi Access, which is door access systems. This device here, the Cloud Gateway Ultra, I get it right, all right, has the UniFi network portion already built into it. So all in one, you don't need to download any software. Simple, easy to configure. This UniFi network will do access point switches and their routers. So generally what you need for a normal base network can be run directly off this unit, and it can handle over 30 Ubiquiti devices. That doesn't mean 30 devices like a phone or anything like that. 30 things like switches and access points that can be managed by it. The advantage also of this over the UniFi Express is this will run Ubiquiti's full intrusion prevention service as well, so you can get all of those things for IDS and all the options that they call in there. You will see some speed tests that we've done over on our YouTube channel. We expect this to get round about the gig. It's what it should be able to get to. Our tests with the UniFi Express were pretty close to that, so this has got a little bit more power, so there should be no reason why you can't get a gig connection out of this. A really great all-round unit. Like I said, you've got the controller built in, you've got a four-port switch. Let that refocus. You've got a four-port switch with a WAN, or maybe you've got a three-port with two WANs as well. USB-C powered, really easy to use. Hopefully that's been useful. Head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got plenty more box openings on network, wireless, and firewall devices. How-to guides, like I said, what do I need to run the Cloud Gateway Ultra, and how do I set it up, and all of those type of things. So why don't you subscribe and stay up to date?